An all-star cast in a 1940s gangster movie? What could go wrong? Well... How's it going, everybody? Welcome to the film review, episode number 114. And the film I'm going to be reviewing for you guys today is Gangster Squad. Gangster Squad is directed by Ruben Fleischer, who previously directed Zombieland and 30 Minutes or Less, and it stars Josh Brolin, Ryan Gosling, Emma Stone, and Sean Penn. Now, the film focuses on 1940s Los Angeles, where the gangster Mickey Cohen is running the town. And it's up to John O'Mara, an L.A. cop, to put together a team of cops to take down Cohen's racket all over town. Now, I'm a big fan of gangster crime movies, and this one had a great cast, so I figured Gangster Squad would be a great addition to the genre. Unfortunately, this film is anything but great.
Now, I don't blame the actors here, because they do the best with what they're given. Sean Penn, in particular, is fun to watch chewing the scenery as Mickey Cohen. He adds a certain panache and flair to the part that always makes him interesting to watch. Josh Brolin also does a decent job here as O'Mara, trying to bring something to the role beyond what's on the page. And we get fun supporting turns from the likes of Ryan Gosling and Robert Patrick. Also, the film has a nice look to it, really seeping itself in the 1940s aura and environment.
But that's all the compliments I can give it.
The script here is so poorly written. Will Beale literally takes every gangster cliche, hits frappe on the blender, and comes up with this piece of crap script. The characters are all stock types with absolutely no character development whatsoever. Most of the characters are cartoony without a doubt, and I could care less what happened to anyone in this film. Gangster Squad is also an incredibly predictable film to boot, so there was absolutely no tension at all since I knew what was going to happen throughout the entire film. And the film is also way too stylized. Director Ruben Fleischer, whose work I enjoyed on Zombieland, has nothing to work with here, so he tries to distract the audience with flashy, slow-motion gunfights that would look cool in a video game, but ultimately don't matter since there's no vested interest in what's happening on screen. The tone is another big problem here. At times it'll be really intense and violent, and yet there are moments where it's almost light and playful, which makes the film feel very schizophrenic. It's even hypocritical in terms of its violence. At one point, a character questions if what they're doing is right, which is all fine and good, but then soon after switches back to stylized violence that's glorified to the extreme, and it really left a bad taste in my mouth.
Ultimately, I'm going to give Gangster Squad a C-. I was very disappointed with this film. All its potential is squandered in poor writing, character development, and overly stylized violence. This was just an enormous waste of time and talent with everyone involved here. Do not see Gangster Squad. So that's it for this review. My next review will be up on Thursday when I review Broken City, the new thriller starring Mark Wahlberg and Russell Crowe. And if you like this review, hit that subscribe button down there so you can get more reviews from me. Anyway, thank you for watching, and I will see you on the other side.